Hello my dear students, hope you all are fit and fine. Today I am going to cover chapter 1 operating system for grade 5. The topics that we are going to cover today is the introduction part, features of an operating system and structure of an operating system. So let's get started. Introduction. Operating system. What is an operating system? Operating system is an interface between user and computer. Let me give you an example. Have you ever seen a car without a driver? I am sure no. Similarly, operating system acts as a driver for the computer. So without operating system, you cannot operate the computer. Operating system is required to operate a computer. And that is why it acts like an interface between user and computer. To explain more, I'll take the help of this diagram. You see there are three things: computer, operating system and user. Operating system lies between computer and user. Let's understand how the computer works with the operating system. So whenever a instruction is given to the computer, it gets converted into a language that computer understand, that is the computer language. Then it is being sent to CPU for processing. The CPU takes the processed data, give it back, and then it is shown to the user in the desired format. So then it is shown to the user. So basically, who is helping us to convert the language, to send it for CPU, taking back from CPU and then showing it to desired format? That is the operating system. So that is why it is very, very useful to us, and that is how it helps overall activities of a computer. It controls overall activities of a computer. Okay, let me give an example of our operating system. Windows, Mac, these all are examples of operating system. Now you can well relate what I am trying to make you understand. Now next we have features of an operating system. For features, we have first feature as user interface, second process management, third resource management, fourth memory management, and fifth file management and handling network communication. Let's talk about each one of them in brief. First, user interface. What is user interface? When you interact with the operating system by graphical interface, that is called as user interface. Have you ever noticed when you open your desktop, you see icons with a graphical means images. For example, my computer with a computer picture, recycle bin with a trash picture, so that you can understand the icons, you can operate the computer very nicely, right? So that is how it gives you a user interface, an interface that user interacts with. Second thing is process management. As we all know that computer processing is going on. Everything, whatever you do, is a process. So who handles all the processes is the operating system. Resource management. Now what is resource management? Resources are like that is being attached to the system. For example, memory, processor, like printer, scanner. So these all are the resources. So who manages all resources? Again, operating system. Next we have memory management. Now we all know that in laptop we are being assigned with the memories where we can store our data. So how those memory get freed, get allocated when there is nothing to be kept, or how these all is arranged, who does all management is the operating system. Operating system assigns memory to task and whenever required. Alright. Then we have file management. File management, again file system. We all use file system in storing and managing our data. So operating system supports file management system that allows us to organize our files in like you can delete, you can copy files, you can move files, all things are being done by with the help of operating system. Next we have handling network communication. Now network communication is when you are connected to the different network, for example Wi-Fi, hotspot, so all these things connecting and all is supported by the operating system and is handled by the operating system. I'm sure you all understood all features. Okay, let's move ahead. Let's understand the structure of an operating system. Now my dear students, structure comprises of four layers. Operating system structure comprises of four layers, and those are hardware, operating system, system programs and application programs. What is hardware? We all know hardware consists of CPU, main memory and all input output devices. So the inner layer is hardware. Next we have operating system. We have just studied what is an operating system. It's a software that acts as interface between user and computer, and it supports features like memory, file management and all network communication. So operating system is the second layer. Then third we have system program. Now what is system program? That consists of systems, like program of the system, for example compiler, assembler, linker. So these all are the system programs. Then we have application programs. Now what is application program? It depends on what use you are, like for what use you are using a particular application. For example, I want to shop online, so I'll be using Amazon Flipkart. You are taking online classes, so you have Zoom. A person working in a bank is using a banking software, so he has his application is that. So understood, application program depends on the users. Okay, who is using what? So these four are the layers of an operating system. Let me relate to an example. When you go and buy a computer, you get a hardware. When you get the operating system installed in it, that and then the computer started. You have the Windows installed or Macintosh installed. Okay. Third thing, system program that we have in common. That, for example, you have compiler, assembler, linkers, paint, and all things that is common. Then we have application program. That depends on our use. I want to use a particular application, so I will go for the same. So I hope these all things are clear. So this was the today's topic. So with again a quick revision, we did four topics: introduction, then we studied features of an operating system, and then we did structure of an operating system. Three topics we did. So thank you so much for listening. Make sure before when you watch this video, you should have a pencil and book in your hands. All right, bye. Thank you.